All right, so as course designers, you know that finding or creating visually consistent images for your course content can be a real challenge. It's a real time tiger, right? To find that right image, that consistent image across an entire course. An average course probably has 20, 30, 40 or more images in the course. But what if you could generate the perfect image for your course, custom, on theme, and cohesive in no time? So no more scrolling through stock photos. I'm gonna show you how AI Assistant and Storyline can do just that. Save you a ton of time finding the right image. Let me show you how that works. So in this first slide, I have a welcome slide for my employee health and wellness course. I'm using a stock image that looks pretty good. One of the challenges with stock photos is that they don't have that consistent look and feel as you move from slide to slide. You move from stock photo to stock photo. There's different photographers, different lighting, and just doesn't really have that cohesive look. So we'll look at how we can really work with the AI generated images, not only to come up with the image that matches the style and the context that we're looking for, but also to help create a visual cohesiveness across our course. So here's what we're going to do. First thing I'm going to do is just get rid of this image. Goodbye. And let's come up here to the home tab on the ribbon, and then you can see we have the options here for insert image. We'd also see those images available to us under the insert tab as well. So we can insert image and bring this open. All right, so here is the generate AI image window. We need to just add a description for the type of image we're looking for. So for this opening slide, just something like a modern office that encourages or highlights employee health and wellness. Now here's the neat part, we have the different styles. So these are the ready-made styles. You can see a preview of them with our little cat here. You can see, get an idea of how these are going to look. So what I would recommend when you're just getting started is really take the same prompt and then insert each of the images into different slides, just so you get an idea of how these different styles look. The one that I really like is the painterly, so I'll select painterly. And here's what's really neat, you get to see the actual prompt that we're using. So you could copy that and then modify it. And then there's even a custom prompt option, which we'll look at, where you could, you know, make variations of this. So I'll stick with this painterly. You have the aspect ratio. I know I want the landscape view because this is going to go on the homepage slide, which is the full width slide. And let's go and just generate the image. So what's happening here is this is happening in real time. So the storyline is going to generate four different previews for us to see really if that image is getting close to what we like. It's just fantastic with the style right here. I really like that paintery or the paint or watercolory kind of style. Now, when we have these here, one thing that I almost always do when I'm building a course right now is I'm going to add these to media library. So I may only want one image right here, but I don't know later down the line, I might want to use that image or a similar image later. So I might just come in here and add some of these images to my media library just so they're available to me. And then I start to think about, okay, well, let's just drill down into this first image. So we click view, get an idea right here. And then we've got the thumbnails, but fantastic styling right here. You've got the plants, you've got the watercolor styles, adds that splash of color. And if you find one you like, you can insert it from here, or we can click cancel just to get back to this view, find the image that you like and click insert. Fantastic. Now I'd probably move that to the back just so it fits underneath everything. And like anything, I might need to crop it a little bit just to bring it in and make it work for this image. Fantastic. Now, a couple other things you can do in is you're starting to look at your course. You think, well, you know, I've got this kind of this mixed match styles that are going on in my course. Maybe I could come in and start to refine the images. So we could actually replace images that already exist and replace them with AI generated images. So what we can do is just select the image. We can right click and we can replace that picture. So we could choose a file, content library, media library, but nope, we're going to generate an image with AI. So we'll click that. And that brings open. Notice how it remembers the previous style that we used, the painterly, which is really helpful when you're going through this in a production process. Now I'm going to drop in a prompt here for that square image just to depict healthy physical health in an office. Now down below the aspect ratio, we have the square and we have a portrait option. These will generate images and the composition will be suited to the actual aspect ratio. So even though you can crop images, it's best to really select the general aspect ratio that you're going for. So in this case, I think that's mostly square. That'll probably be the best choice. Okay, and we'll generate that image. And again, AI is going to go through the process, generating those four preview images for us. If I like them overall, I can go ahead and click them and keep them in my media library. So this one, it added some text, which I don't think I want, but I do like these. And I'll grab those. And then I think this one probably seems like the happiest image. So I'll click replace. And now I could go through the images in my course to just to use that to create that consistent style, that consistent visual voice for my course. Now, one last thing I want to do is highlight what we can also do with images, and that is to use your own custom prompts. So I'm going to come back in this, let's say this first one here, and let's bring in a new image. So we'll say insert image. So I'm going to drop in that same prompt we used earlier for that homepage image. It's choosing Painterly, which is the previous style. And then we also have the previous aspect ratios. So this time I'll say use a widescreen. But I'm going to come down here to my custom. So I scroll all the way down and choose custom. I have a custom prompt that I dropped in here. But what's really nice, though, let's say that you liked a lot of what you saw with the Painterly. You could copy that prompt, come down here to the custom style, and then start to modify, select it, whatever is in there, paste it, and then you can modify aspects of this to get the version of the painting that you like. So maybe it's not a watercolor, right? Maybe it's an oil painting technique or something like that. So you could slightly modify. And then once you have something refined the way you like, I would copy it to a separate document and use that as the prompt that you use going forward. So for example, let me just show you one that I've been using is a kind of inspired by national park posters. So let me show you what I was using for this course before I got started. So it's going to go through and generate four of those parks, but it's going to be these earth tone colors and mutings based on national park posters. So you've got some of the mountains in the background. Absolutely love this one. I'll just drop that in real quick. But that's kind of the look and feel I was going for when I was first building the course. I thought, okay, come up with something that inspires you, that you enjoy, create a custom prompt around that, and then copy and paste that each time for your custom prompts if you don't want to use any one of the built-ins, or take the built-ins and then make a variation of that one for you. All right, folks, that's how easy it is to use AI Assistant in Storyline to create custom images and just a few clicks, giving you so much more control over your visuals. Now your courses can look exactly as you want with a cohesive look and really the perfect images to align with your content.